Alright, so got finished the spraying yesterday and now it's a bit windy today, but we got some other stuff going on. We have these fellas here. They've got a ram shearing trailer. What it does, it just holds the rams, immobilizes them just so they can't kick, because shearing rams is quite dangerous. They're plugging away at them. We've actually had a few other farmers bring their rams to here so they can all get shorn on one day. Yeah, it's really good. Makes it really safe and better for the rams, because they're not kicking and struggling against the shearers. Right, the ram shearing fellas have finished, headed off. They finished all of our rams. We're just giving them a bit of backline now, so that they don't have any lice. We're using Avenge. If you've ever heard of Avenge, that's our choice of backline. Yeah. Then Dad will cart them home and they can go back out in the paddock. All right, so we got finished all the ram shearing yesterday, and while we were doing that, Dad came out, got some the mid-range of lambs in the yards out north here. We're just crutching them at the moment. I will be going back spraying later on, but while the dew was drying off the plants, I thought I'd come out here and give Dad a hand for the first couple of hours. Alright, so we got 205 done. I've left Dad out here. He's just sitting down to have some smoke, eh? And I'm heading home and I'll get into the spraying. Thank you. So, we got this paddock sprayed. What we are spraying for is wild oats. I don't know where they originated from or anything, but they're an oat and they're wild, and they will outcompete wheat and dramatically decrease the yield. Yeah, there's a few of them, there's not heaps. Here's one of them here. They just kind of grow out like that, and then they'll just throw these seed heads way up. So you think, oh no, there's none out there. And then all of a sudden, one day you look out and you're like, oh no, I just look like a terrible farmer. There's weeds all through this paddock and looks bad. But anyway, it is what it is. We've sprayed them out now. And they shouldn't grow. This little patch that I'm walking down, it's where a head was blocked on the air seeder. And I'm walking down here. Oh, a head was blocked on the air seeder and nothing grew here. So that's why there's no crop. Walking down here, there used to be a fence line run through right here. From those trees to left of that tree a little bit. Now you see back there, hardly any weeds in it. It's clean as. Because this used to be a little paddock that was, they used to graze sheep on it and they didn't crop it. But this side's been cropping for a fair bit of its lifetime. And you'll see all these weeds that are coming up through it, they are more robust against the chemical. They have more resistance against the chemical that we use. So, I don't know. I guess it's just interesting to see that this side of the old fence line still is clean. The chemical's working well. But this side, it's not working quite so well. Admittedly, this strip, there's probably more weeds growing here than in the rest of the paddock, just because it doesn't have the crop competing with it. Yeah, but it's very, very interesting to see. So I've just pulled up this wheat plant to have a look at its roots, and you can see just in there, that's actually the seed. The seed that we sowed is still hanging on the plant, and yeah, it's pretty interesting. A lot of the roots broke off under the ground, but it's quite promising that there's still some moisture in the soil. We'll be after a rain soon though. Right, so while I'm out here having a yarn to you guys, I thought I'd just walk down here and find a decent wheel track and just show you what the crop dividers are doing, or what I understand them to be doing. So this is our row here. This is our wheel track. One there, one 3 meters over that way. And this is what's squashed down. So you'll see that there's some that's squashed down. The wheel track's from over there to over there. Now what I think the crop dividers are doing, you see all of these are being squashed this way. These ones that are straight in front, that are shorter, they've just been pushed over. It's no escaping that. But the crop dividers, they just come through and they push it aside and let the wheel run through. Very evident over here. You can see where it's been pushed aside like this, and only the edge of the tire runs over it, if anything runs over it. So what it does, it just stops any more getting sucked in. It just limits your losses, and I wouldn't be surprised if, well, most of that comes back, really. Even something like this that's pretty angled over, yeah, I think it'll probably stand up. But anyway, wait and see. I'm really happy with them. I lowered the front ones just a little bit for the wheat, because the wheat's a bit shorter than the canola. And yeah, they're doing a really good job. I recommend crop dividers. If you've got a self-propelled sprayer, yeah, I recommend investing in crop dividers. The sooner you do it, the sooner you can be saving money. All right, we got that sprayed. So everything up here is done. Now we just got to fill up and go back down to Dad's place. I'm just coming around this patch of trees. The ag leader is steering along the line that I've already made. Doing a marvellous job. Farming's getting easier and easier by the day. I love it. Right, so we got finished that last paddock, got to this next paddock. I just thought I'd show you something out here. See how good this wheat looks? I'll show you something. Have a look at this. You might not know it. That is actually wheat. And the only difference between that nice dark green looking paddock over there and this bit that's sown here is we haven't put any spray on this. We didn't kill the weeds for a start. We didn't put any pre-emergent. We still put some fertilizer in with it. We just ran the wheat out here. We had a little bit left over when we were changing to barley. So we ran it out in this paddock, the sheep come along and eat it. It's a good deal. But I thought it was quite interesting that that paddock, that patch there, those few strips, looks shocking. But this paddock here looks really good. All right, so finished spraying for today. I had a go at doing a live drone stream to Facebook while I was going. It kept dropping out, but I was filming that drone footage while I was doing that, which is pretty cool. First go at that, so we'll see how we go. I'll do it to YouTube next time, give everyone a bit more warning. Yeah, but definitely keen to do more live videos, or to do some live videos. Let me know in the comments if you want to see some live videos. Yeah, anyway, that'll do for this video. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like the video, give it a thumbs up if you liked it, and subscribe if you haven't already. And yeah, we'll see you in the next one.